It is a disease most of you have probably never heard of, but it's very likely you've been exposed to it.
The disease-causing fungus travels through the wind. It's almost impossible to get away from, and it can debilitate you. On the Health Beat, Dr. Ramo has what you need to know about the desert disease.
Something dangerous may lurk just beneath the surface of New Mexico's starkly beautiful desert landscape.
We do know it's in the soil in New Mexico.
Travels on the wind, and on a day like this, it is virtually impossible to protect yourself from it.
Do you inhale the fungus when it's blowing or disturbed or coming out of the soil and into the air?
It's called valley fever or coccidiomycosis. It's a fungus, and very few New Mexicans have ever heard of it.
The infectious form of it, lies dormant in the soil, and then when it gets into the human body, it can reproduce and cause a disease.
Valley fever seems like any other flu-like disease, with coughing, fever, fatigue, muscle aches, and sometimes a rash. Most people can fight off this fungus without ever knowing they've actually contracted it. But valley fever can spread to the bones, joints, even the central nervous system. And if it spreads, the disease can be devastating, sometimes even deadly.
The first year that I was ill, I slept 23 hours a day.
Pat White contracted the disease in Arizona. The disease baffled her doctors. It snapped her strength and nearly cost her her life before valley fever was finally diagnosed as the cause of her mysterious medical illness.
The chronic cases require very aggressive therapy with IV medications that act against the fungus, and it usually is prolonged therapy.
Pat's case was one of 10,000 diagnosed in Arizona last year, while New Mexico recorded only a handful. Scientists believe New Mexico's number would be significantly higher if doctors and their patients knew more about the disease.
And we usually get only about 20 or 50, depending on the year. It varies each year. But we suspect that there are quite a bit more.
Officials from Arizona met with New Mexico public health physicians Monday to raise awareness about valley fever. Here is what you need to know. Because the disease is spread by the wind, it has no exact boundary. But scientists find that it's mostly located in southern New Mexico and Arizona.
Stops. Generally, we think somewhere around Albuquerque.
The best way to prevent valley fever is not to inhale dust. But that's easier said than done with New Mexico's wind.
You don't need to inhale too much of the infectious form of the fungus to get the illness, so it does take quite an effort to...
There clearly is some difference between New Mexico's environment and that of Arizona. But the southern part of the state is certainly ripe for an increased incidence of this disease, and particularly with all the wind. If you've been traveling to that part of the state or live in that part of the state, you develop symptoms that simply won't go away. Muscle aches, night sweats, persistent cough and fever. You should check with your doctor because you may have that disease, and it can be easily treated with medication that kills the fungus. For Health Beat, I'm Dr. Barry Ramo, KOAT Action 7 News.
Arizona reported 30 deaths from valley fever last year. Now, if you recognize the symptoms and you've been to southern New Mexico or Arizona recently, see your doctor right away.